welcome to the old
me. You motherfucker.
It's their biggest gamble yet.
Go on, Jay, baby, let's get that oil.
The stakes have never been higher.
If we don't hit, I don't know how many millions, but it's going to be a huge loss for you.
We need to hit this one.
She's got a gun.
She's got a gun.
Now, one angry rancher.
Take this rig and get the hell out of here.
Can put a stop to it.
They're going to respect me or they can get the fuck out.
And all hell is about to break loose.
Get out of here! Get out of here! Get out of here!
The pressure is building. All for a taste.
Seven wants more of
you. Of black gold. Previously on Black Gold.
Come on! Hurt that motherfucker!
Big Dog Drillin' inked a deal to go wildcatting.
I'll be keeping an eye out.
Ooh, that's not good news.
Watch out!
But the plan put our roughnecks in the firing line of a hot-tempered, angry landowner.
Why do you have a gun?
To keep stupid rednecks like you from f***ing up my f***.
On the rig, news of a possible promotion ignited a power struggle between tool pushers Jerry Chansey and Freddie Moore.
There you go!
I don't give a f*** what you signed up for!
Now the stress is tearing the rig apart, one rough neck at a time.
What the f*** in my face, dude?
What the f***?
How you on my face?
I'm tired of hearing you!
It's only day two on the Wildcat well.
Let's go! Put that damn safety camera on there!
But the battle has just begun.
Go over and help me hook up that jet line! Idiot! Idiots!
Tool pusher Freddie Moore is bucking for a promotion. And every roughneck who gets in his way is getting an earful.
They don't listen. Hell, they forget from one day to the next what you're supposed to do out here. They don't ever forget when payday is, but they forget how to f***ing roughneck out here. Bull. Push it back in there like we had it. There's a time and a place for the standing around in the bull. Today ain't one of them. They're on my time now. They're on big dog time.
Y'all get out here and pick up all the damn trash on the ground.
I want to move up in that damn office. That's just like when I was a lead tong hand. I moved up to a driller and I said, hell with that, I want to move out to that trailer house. Now my goal is to be into that office.
Hey, take it back off, rub that tan, motherfucker ain't working. Let's go, come on, take it off.
For Freddie to get his promotion, he's going to have to count on his roughnecks to make him look good. Trouble is, two of them are distracted. One is love-struck.
He's a sensitive big fella.
While the other is just dumbstruck.
You doing? Hurry up and wrap that. Yeah, like you never done this before.
Me and my wife, we were married 6 weeks yesterday. I've been so emotional. I just met the woman and married her quick. I want a full life with her, man.
Get him off her. You know what the you doing?
I really don't know what the hell's going on, but I'm gonna try like hell to make it out here because I've done a lot of things in my past and I want to get as far away from it as I can.
Make your thoughts mine!
This job might be Twist's last chance to make an honest living.
I got 9 felonies. I got burglary habitation, theft of a motor vehicle, arson, 3 dope cases, a pistol case, theft 1,500 to 20,000, and aggravated assault with a deadly weapon. With 9 felonies on my rap sheet, just the slightest little mistake, I'm gonna go to jail for 25 to life and you'll never see me again.
You'll get one chance, that's it, I'll get my size 7-inch boot. It's gonna
on one place only.
Damn.
Huh?
You couldn't move any slower.
You want me to pick up the pace? I'll pick it up, bro.
What the f***?
I'm trying to please you, bro. This job is very important to me, dude. Straight up, I got a lot riding on this. Anything you need, I got you, bro.
Only thing I can say is a good thing. He's your driller and I'm not.
That's what the f*** you doing.
With Freddie riding his roughnecks, they've only managed to dig 1,000 feet. Now he's got to deal with the evening shift.
What up, sucker?
Never been behind asking.
You get dark out here on the rig,
bro. I know, bro. Drilling pretty good.
Yeah, mother. You still got rub on your arms and
yeah.
Cheston and Brandon have been at each other's throat for 2 days straight.
I mean, I worked lead tongue last year. I just don't like working lead tongue. I mean, I graduated up to that tongue. I worked my ass off, and I'm taking the other tongues.
They're my tongues.
Nah, boom.
There they are.
I'll wrap them, boom.
Kill you, lead tongue.
That's my little sister.
If Cheston is gonna get respect, the first person he'll need on his side is Brandon.
Hey! Start pushing him even, bro. I'm gonna fall out the pipe rack. He's a cool guy, don't get me wrong, but he just rubs me the wrong way sometimes. Deep down, we're friends. You know, we love to hate each other. We're just so much alike, you know? He just gets on my nerves sometimes, man. And he's always coming and touching me. Hey, what's up, Brandon? What's going on? My nothing, mother. Don't touch me like that. Damn it. Get it. Get it. Don't just look at the mother. Go get it.
Shades are gone.
They were right there.
Is that them?
They're gonna sink, Cheston. You gotta go get them. Get that bucket. Why you got the stick, bro? Why you're in there?
Man.
If you're gonna
I'm
be in
there,
I'm
only doing this because I'm already muddy, dude.
You ain't doing it for me?
Not because I'm your bitch.
Okay, then. I'm not getting in there and getting them buckets. That's his job. It ain't mine. He's a grunt worker. I'm not. You might as well get those. Well, he didn't even complain or anything, man. He just jumped in, you know, kind of like my little brother.
Yeah, he's kind of like an older brother to me. Unfortunately, I lost my older brother when I was 21, so we kind of compete against one another, so it makes it fun, you know? You dumb. See, man?
Come on, mother.
Push it.
Yeah, you're already in there, dude. Why are you going to get mad? Damn it.
You just make me eat that, fool.
I've been eating them all connections all day long, bro. It seemed, you know, but that's just the way it goes, man.
For Cheston, working on an oil rig is all about who's got your back, and he's not sure if Brandon does.
Brandon, you don't like me?
I don't.
Really?
Yeah. So I'm just gonna ride with you?
No, I told James we didn't get along.
That's what you told James? Why'd
yeah,
you tell James?
Because we don't, Cheston.
We don't get along?
No, we don't.
How come we ride to work and we roughneck together and we work hard together?
Well, we still don't get along, mother.
Well, then fine.
When did we get along?
Why is that?
But why?
I don't know.
Expose it.
What do you mean, expose it?
I don't know. Tell me why.
Tell him what you was telling me up here on the floor.
You're telling me why you don't like me, too. Give me a description of why you don't like me.
Because you chomp, bro. You're always
I ain't
talking.
Chomping.
You're always talking, bro.
I ain't chomping.
You're always talking. You're always talking, bro.
Well, then,
all the time.
I'm keep
yapping, 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 yippity yap, bro.
You know
that's all I
mean.
That's all I hear all day long. On the road, every day.
What?
Yep.
Hey, I listen to you yap back too, so.
Okay.
You know, same
thing. Are we getting along?
Not now.
Okay.
Not now?
We never do.
What
do we get along?
I'll see you later then.
Toodles.
Toodles.
What the f is Toodles?
That's your nickname, bitch.
Brandon just wants to be the Billy Badass, and if he wants to have that title, we can get him a little WWE belt, and we'll put it in the Billy Badass of the Rig if he wants.
You're yapping. See what I mean? Just constantly, always barking. Like a little puppy.
If Freddie doesn't have enough problems with his roughnecks, he's got another one on the horizon.
Whose truck is that, man?
Is that the land lease lady?
Yeah, that's Peggy, bro.
I'm coming out here today to meet the tool pusher. If these guys aren't going to follow the rules, I'm going to be out here and they don't want that.
Coming up, Peggy lays down the law.
If you can't handle the problems, I most certainly will.
And later, Tank's home life follows him to the rig.
Here's your stuff.
Please, it's all over now.
I can't live like this anymore.
Everything we had's over.
There's no more talking.
That's all?
Peggy Hauser is on a mission to protect her land.
Dan, don't tell me that, dog.
She's already caught the roughneck speeding.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, that's a running with that
shotgun, dude.
Oh.
Hey. What the f***? She got a gun, dude.
Oh, my God.
Now Freddy's got to pay the price.
Hi. Are you the tool pusher?
Freddy Moore.
Peggy Hauser. I own the land. I just thought I'd bring this apple pie.
After 20 years in the oil field, Freddie knows one thing. Beware of landowners' barren gifts.
Well, I brought you an apple pie. It doesn't look like you need it. So, Mr. Moore, I want to make it very clear to you that this is my backyard. I'm going to be here to make sure you guys are taking care of things and abiding by the rules. My rules.
Well, you know,
I caught a couple of your roughnecks speeding down the road going about 80 miles an hour the other day.
Okay.
And I got on their ass a little bit. I just want to make sure you guys are out here taking care of things.
You know, I can't be with them at all times.
If you can't handle the problems, I most certainly will.
I try myself to keep the trash picked up because I know how roughnecks are. They'll throw it on your road.
Well, I certainly hope not. Because if I catch them, I'm going to deal with them and then I'm going to come and deal with you. So should I call you instead of Autry?
Well, I'd rather deal with me and you than take it downtown.
We'll see.
Yes, ma'am. Have a great day. Well, I mean, you know, I don't mind seeing her. I mean, hell, she's a pretty woman, but hell, she got an attitude like one of them roughnecks out there. She get pissed off in a hurry. I wonder if she put any arsenic in there.
<laughs> 50 miles east.
Something like that?
Right there, dude.
That's good, brother.
Where everybody can see it, you know, because she really basically saved my life, man.
Tank is putting his new love's heart on his sleeve permanently.
Remember the first day we came on location during the rig move? That rancher was like...
I wasn't there, but I heard about this.
The rancher's like, speed limit's 20. It's their road.
So is this rancher like a hard ass?
I heard it was a chick. I've never heard some stuff. I mean, like, she held 10 guys up at gunpoint until, like, shift change to their boss gets
10 roughnecks?
I swear to God.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, she has it out for us, bro. That's
really?
Yeah. Dude, no. How's that arm feel?
Good, dude.
I know you can take it.
In Odessa, Texas.
Too damn old roughneck, gotta do something.
Drilling legend Gerald Williams is about to put his savings on the line. He's looking for a new venture to get him back in the black.
One step closer to where I want to be. Been a long time coming, but it looks like it's fixing to materialize.
Looks like you lost a little weight there, huh?
Yeah, I was just wondering if you had any driller spots out here, Freddie.
Well, you know, right now, we're just all filled up.
With no jobs available on Rig 28. Drilling solo is Gerald's best hope while he waits for something in the oil fields to open up.
How you doing?
Fine, sir. How are you today? What
can I do for you?
Well, I understand you got some rigs for lease.
What kind of rig you looking at?
Probably a spudder.
Spudder rig?
Yeah.
That's my favorite. Get the most water for your money.
There you go.
In West Texas, more than half of its residents get their water from wells.
How are you going about finding your water, sir? Are you a witcher, or?
Well, I've never witched water, but I was certainly hoping I could get you to teach me how. I'm figuring if I can get 3 holes a week, that's my goal, is 3 completed holes a week, is to do that.
3 holes a week, you can make your payments on your rig, keep it up kept, put a little money in your back pocket. No 2 holes are the same. They're not going to drill the same. The formations are not the same. You may get on a hole and be there for 3 days beating on that rock.
It's been a long time since I've done it, but I think I can make me and you both some money.
Well, you want to meet in the morning and stand that rig up, see what you got?
All right, buddy.
See if we can knock a hole in the ground.
I'll bet we can.
All right.
Appreciate it.
All right.
Thanks, sir. Drilling's what I love. It's what I've done all my life. So if I can pull this off, at least in this little rig from this guy, run it for a while on my own. So hopefully it'll be a win-win for me and him both.
Gerald's made the commitment. All he's got to do now is break it to his wife. Coming up, as the tool pushers increase the pressure.
You should have kicked them out.
It's a process of elimination.
A roughneck's home life blows up in his face.
I got those guys in the rig. I guess they're my family now.
In the blue-collar town of Odessa,
the dogs are always ready, sir.
The legendary Gerald Williams is hosting a barbecue to celebrate his new money-making scheme.
They have a little cigarette ashes on them, but that never hurt nobody.
But there's one thing he's got to do. Tell his wife, Rosie.
Well, Mom, I've come up with a new plan.
How dangerous?
I talked to this feller named Mark, and he's got some rigs. And he's willing to lease me one.
What kind of rig?
Well, it's a little water well rig.
How dangerous?
I'm not going to say it's not dangerous. It is. It's a rig.
The last time we had spoken about anything, that you were never going to go back onto the rig.
Of course, everything. You can go to the grocery store and get shot. So everything's dangerous.
I know drilling is in Gerald's bones, but I was really relieved the day that he got fired from Big Dog. I knew I wasn't going to have to worry anymore about him. Now that he has started on the water wells, I'm worried that eventually he's going to want to go back to the oil rigs.
I think it would be really lucrative for us, and I'd really like to try.
It sounds like you've already made up your mind.
Well, no. Yeah, I want to do it.
It's kind of frustrating because once he sets his mind to it, he does exactly what he does. I really don't like it, but I'll be there for him.
Hey, here's to the drilling business, guys.
Right. Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Back at the rig. The evening crew are 1,500 feet deep into the Wildcat well.
Hey, pull that board!
I've already made 500 feet. Got about 300 more feet to go to reach my goals for the day. Then I'll be satisfied.
And it's drilling a little better now. It was drilling like 35, 40 foot. It's broke down the formation, and it's drilling probably like 80 foot an hour right now.
Peace.
If Freddie is going to impress the front office, he's going to need his driller to push harder.
Hey! It starts for a couple seconds every time you walk off, and then it just dies down.
One of the rig's two engines is down.
This is out, too.
With only one engine, the rig's not going to make much progress. And if driller James doesn't get it fixed, his failure will fall on Freddy's head.
Oh no, Freddy, I got it to start for a couple seconds and it keeps turning itself off.
When you get a motor go down like that, you gotta try to figure out what the problem is before you get any deeper.
I got the overall part. Yeah, I did. I checked these.
So we figure out what our problem is. It's a process of elimination.
After 2 hours of tinkering, they still got no solution. But it's the end of Freddy's shift, which means he's forced to leave the crippled rig in Jerry's hands. With a superintendent position in his sights, this could be the chance Jerry needs to secure the promotion.
We've got two floor motors. If one of them goes down, we're in bind. Because in order to drill, we have to have both of them. And I don't know what's wrong with that one just right now. I don't know. They could shut us down.
But with the rig hobbling along on a single engine, the increased stress throws the engine out of gear.
Let go!
Oh, now what?
Everything's going.
You better watch it, dude. Pump up, you up.
Deep it up.
Jerry?
No, James.
James? I should have been a whole lot deeper than what I'm at right now. I mean, it's just little things are steady breaking down. And there ain't nothing you can do about it.
That's, it's in low gear. I don't know how to change gears on this.
I have to answer to the men that, you know, they got people breathing down their backs. So, as they say, crap runs downhill, you know.
But you should have kicked them out. That's a blind leading the blind.
With 30 years of experience on a rig,
be a bar, try to push it in.
Jerry's not going to let a slow driller or mechanical problems come between him and a job in the front office.
Which way was it turning?
Everything's turning.
Okay, shove it in gear.
You got to thank for James. He's slow. He's a good man. He just slow.
Hurry up. All right, go ahead and drill like that.
He don't think. He's got to learn to think for himself.
By evening shift, the rig is finally up and running, and the crew is gearing up to drill deeper into the Wildcat well.
I'm fixing to get up there and drill myself. I will make it up.
James's incompetence is spreading doubt amongst the crew.
What happens if we hit gas? I mean, you think we'll be out of a job? Or?
Well, I don't know, dude.
If we hit gas, my ass is going to be running. I know that.
You might be smaller than me, but if we hit gas, I bet I can run faster.
No, I don't think so. Upwind from the H2S? I'm gone.
For a roughneck, the most feared unknown is H2S gas. If they hit an unexpected pocket, the rig could end up in a ball of flames.
God dang it!
Hey! Now, Justin's worst fear may have come true.
I thought he was going to let it drill.
After a day of nonstop problems,
hey, you two motherfucking
day! James is losing control of his rig.
Go down there and check out that pot.
Lucky for the crew, the alarm is signaling a loss in pressure, not H2S. If James can't solve the problem fast, he'll have to answer to one angry tool pusher.
61 foot hour, that ain't near enough. He needs at least 100.
This is the second time today Jerry's had to clean up James's mess.
Go down there and find out what he's got closed.
You know, James didn't check all of his valves to make sure which ones were open, which ones were closed. He had the suction closed. You gotta have the suction open to be on the hole.
That sucked dry.
If they're not turning, they're not earning. And the last thing Jerry's gonna do is let a driller come between him and a promotion.
We'll fix it, speed it up. On them RPMs up about 80.
If the rig continues to struggle and it costs Jerry a promotion, James could be kicking rocks before the week's over.
He should be able to handle every situation comes up for.
Find the spot, make it drill.
Twenty-five miles east of Odessa, Gerald is learning the ancient divining art of witching for water.
Maybe we're getting lucky here.
With two sticks and a hunch.
Right there we got complete cross.
For a veteran driller, witching is more like magic than science, but Gerald's got no choice.
You know, witching for water, I've always been skeptical of it. I'd seen it before, but hopefully this will all work out for all of us. But there's a spot, huh?
Yeah, about 2 foot from that ant bed.
Them ants may be smarter than all of us.
There is people to say, you find the red ant bed, and there's water.
That's pretty amazing.
It is, it really is.
But punching a hole through a red ant colony could be a bad idea.
So we're going to want to drill?
Right there, in the ant bed.
All right, here we go.
On a 200-acre parcel of Peggy Hauser's land. The day crew is trying to make up for lost time on James's watch. And the rig's new worm is hustling hard to prove himself.
Come here.
Tell you the truth, damage man's what I'm shooting for, so gotta learn the tricks of the trade. When I got out of jail, I made up my mind I wanted to run as far away from my past as I could.
I want to shine for Oscar, man. I want to show him that I got the balls to do what I need to do when I'm not here and I'm ready to do it. Bar none.
Twist is trying to show people that he's interested in working and interested in doing this job out here. And right now, he's doing a hell of a job. If you take Tank and take Twist and put them together, Tank might be the bigger guy, but Twist is the harder worker than Tank is. Tank's just here for a payday. By the way, where the f*** is Tank?
While Twist is making a solid impression on Freddy, Tank is coming up short.
Oh, where is my little army tank?
You never know about Tank. He's probably in the most unpredictable place that you could ever think of. Well, he's not in there. Have you seen your brother, Tank?
Fat man is on the prowl.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Well, I've been all over this rig, and I ain't found him yet. Oh, Tank! You! Pumpkin, are you in there? Are you in there sleeping, son?
Hell no.
Well, I mean, I've been all over this location looking for you, and that was the last place I could look. Start hosing out this sub, get all these dead bugs out of it, all that rinsed out. Start getting this cleaned up around here. Don't walk around, because when you walk around, I think you're not busy.
I was in the outhouse, and Freddie couldn't find me. I've been texting and on my phone trying to get a hold of my soon-to-be ex-wife. Everything's kind of crumbling down on me again. I don't know what's going on, man. Crazy.
matter, dog?
My wife's leaving me.
Your wife's leaving you?
Yeah.
How come?
I thought she was cheating on me. Then we got in a big-ass fight, and she called her ex-husband. He said he didn't like me anyway from the get-go, so he's not going to let the kids come back to the house. So I got to go when I get off. So, hey, you know, it's a rough neck, you know? You got to roll with the punches. And now, hey, but now I'm clean, so it's easier
but
to do.
But are
with.
You going to stay that way?
Oh, yeah.
Are you going to let this drag you down in the gutter again?
I'm not going to.
Got to roll with the punches.
Well,
what am I
gonna hate to hear that.
That's all right.
But you can't let that drag you down out here, or you're going to be unemployed too, because Oscar ain't going to have you just walking around out here.
Right. Exactly.
You know, we all got a life outside of this drilling rig.
You got it.
If you stay busy, maybe you keep your mind occupied where you don't bother you as near as bad.
Okay. Thanks, boss.
I'm devastated.
Easy money, baby.
She really basically saved my life, man.
I feel bad for Tank.
I feel bad too. I think it was getting married after 6 weeks of meeting the chick.
I don't need to laugh, dude. That's just my opinion. That's cold blooded right there, dude.
I'm just saying.
Wow. It's surreal right now. I knew something was wrong when I looked down, dude. You just lost all stamina. She wrote me this morning. Hi, Hunk of Burning Love. That HBL, that's her pet name for me, Hunk of Burning Love. It's all about the three Fs today.
What's the three Fs?
Fight and fire. I need the third F from you, please, Tank. That's faith that you have in me. I love you with all my heart. You're a warrior mama lay. Jin Jin. You know what? Right there. Right there. Good riddance, you liar. Hey. This means nothing to me now. This means zero. I'm devastated. I used to look at this ring and go, and think about her out here and go, oh God, I can't wait to get home and hold her in my arms. And now I just go, tua. Stinks, man.
Coming up. Tank shot at redemption.
You bring drama to a rig. We don't need all that bullshit.
Is fading fast.
Damn. Here's your stuff.
It's all over now.
I can't live with
everything
this
we had is over.
There's no more talking.
That stinks.
While Tank tries to mend the hole in his heart, Gerald is trying to fill the hole in his wallet. After 30 years in the oil fields, Gerald is back to being a worm.
Damn, it's hot out here today. Now I know why everybody uses a hand.
He and Mark found the perfect spot to drill, but he's sharing the site with Red Ants.
Bastards, this is what everybody loves, 104 degrees and man. Oh! Oh! Damn it, Ants.
The once legendary roughneck has ants in his pants.
Get out of here.
Bye. 15 miles away on the outskirts of Midland, Tank heads home to pack his belongings.
Love him a lot. Me and her, that's on our wedding day. That was our engagement announcement. That's my father. We bought that together. Live well, love much, laugh often. I ain't laughing now. But you know what? I'm clean now, and the old me would just
probably go score some dope, but I can't do that anymore. Got too much to lose. Just clear my stuff out of here. Do the best I can. That's all I got is love notes in here, man. Hi, my amazing husband. Yeah, I love saying husband. Last time I wrote you, we were counting down days. We got married. Now I can give you an official count of how long we've been married. 5 weeks and 4 days. I want you to know that was the best, most wonderful, spectacular day of my life. Becoming Mr. and Mrs. Terry Hannah. I love you so, so much. You're Junior. I'm gonna get a trash bag. Terry, my love, I love you with all my heart. You're Jin Jin. God. All the people I had in my life that I loved and loved me, I don't have them anymore. I don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna do, man. I used to go to my father. I don't have him anymore. I don't have my family anymore. All my some trash bags, man. I got those guys in the rig. That's who I got. That's about it. That's about all I got in this world. I guess they're my family now, man.
Coming up.
This is the kind of crap I'm talking about. I'm tired of it.
A landowner gets dirty.
It's 102 degrees out here. Freddie should have his ass out here doing it.
And a roughneck gets dumped.
That's it? It's all over now?
I can't live like
everything
this
we had's over?
No, there's no more talking.
What's his name? That stinks!
Tank, make sure he's staying busy. Keep up with him, you know what I'm saying? With him, you know, play around with him, make him feel good, whatever.
Yeah, I got you.
Before dawn, just outside of Midland,
greasing up my tongue so I can throw him like I want to.
The daylight crew of Rig 28 gets ready to do battle with the Wildcat Hole.
What's that, Tank? Feeling good? Not really.
But Tank has lost his fighting spirit. After only 6 weeks of marriage, Tank's wife threw him out of the house.
It's over. My little angel there is gone. I mean, I'm used to seeing her every morning when I wake up and when I go to bed. I'm crushed. Living in my truck right now. And slept in my truck last night. I guess I gotta marry this rig, I guess.
First connection of the day, boys! First connection of the day!
Oscar and Twist are trying to help Tank pull it together.
First thing!
Tank, you better put a smile on that face!
Come on, man, you gotta get in a good mood. I know it's rough. I know you are, man. I feel you.
Oscar knows that the big man won't be sympathetic.
You can't drag all your family problems out here on a drilling rig, because if you do, you're in for a hell of a day.
Freddie doesn't need more problems than he's already got.
You bring drama to a rig. We don't need all that.
My day is going probably the longest day of my life. The longest and worst day of my life.
If Tank lets his emotions get the best of him, he may find himself out of a marriage and out of a job.
I hope that he holds his head above water, but I can see the waves like white cabbage right over top of his little noggin.
What the f***, Jennifer?
Here's your please. Stuff. No, this is the rest of your stuff.
Please.
Take it.
No, come here. No,
please. There's nothing else
please.
That I can
you
talk
kidding?
About.
That's it?
There's nothing
that's
else
all?
To talk
that's
about.
All? What's his name, man? What's his name? I'll find out.
I'm going to lose my kids. It's my kids. I need to be away.
No, that's it? That's it? That's it? That's all over now?
I can't live like
everything
this
Everything we had over?
No, I can't live like this.
Jennifer.
Kids,
Jennifer.
There's no more talking.
Jennifer.
No, there's no more.
That's it? That's it?
I can't talk anymore.
You're just gonna leave? That stinks! That stinks! Damn! This is my life right here, man. Story of my life right here. Find somebody good, something happens, man. I shoot myself in the foot every turn I make, man. Here we go again.
Damn. While Tank wrestles with a broken heart, a broken fence has Peggy Hauser mad enough to take down every man on the rig.
It just pisses me off. This is the kind of crap I'm talking about. I'm tired of it. I noticed the other day the cattle guard was all jacked up. I shouldn't have to be out here fixing it in the middle of the afternoon like this. Typical roughnecks can't even drive down the road without screwing something up. It's 102 degrees out here. No, this pisses me off that I'm out here having to do this, and I'm a lady. Freddy should have his ass out here doing it. I know it was one of his roughnecks that screwed up the cattle guard in the first place. A lot of these guys drive big, jacked up trucks, I guess compensating for where they're lacking. There's no way you could hit this and not know that you hit it, to the point to where welders had to come out and re-weld it. I wonder if they can see me from the rig right now over here putting this fence back together that they screwed up. If they were real men, they would have told me. And it could have been fixed a long time ago. They don't like authority in the first place. Most of them have already been to prison. They damn sure don't like taking it from a woman. I'm not playing around. This is the kind of thing right here that'll get the lease pulled.
It's original.